Hey, it's Professor Dave. Let's talk about addition and subtraction.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
As we have just come to understand, math never started out as a bunch of seemingly arbitrary operations meant to confuse and frustrate students. It is simply that our understanding of math has become extremely sophisticated over the past few hundred years. And the fact that all of this existing and sometimes difficult math must be learned before anyone can contribute to the field is what is responsible for the way that so many people despise this subject. But let's remember that math began very simply as part of our language, a set of models and symbols that helped us to communicate ideas and describe our surroundings. Mathematical innovations arose by necessity, and they still do. It's simply that the frontier of today's math lies in an abstract place that very few can understand. By the end of this series, maybe we can all get there, but for now, let's start at the very beginning. What was the very first kind of math that was developed by the human race? That would undoubtedly be arithmetic. Shortly after humans were able to count, we needed symbols to represent those counting numbers, as well as methods to manipulate those numbers in ways that represent real-life concepts. How many people are in the tribe? 2 kids were just born. How many are there now? How many years has the tribe's wisest elder been alive? Once civilizations formed and we began to trade goods with one another, we needed to be able to keep track of inventory, price items appropriately, and so forth. How many apples are in the basket? How many do you want, and how many are now left? Being that we like to count on our fingers, and we have 10 of them, many counting systems were based on a system of 10. There were others based on 20 or even 60, but the one we use today is based on 10. So rather than diving into the anthropology of arithmetic, let's keep our study focused on what can be readily applied. Presently, our conceptualization of the number 10 as the basis for our numerical system is so ingrained in our collective logic that we sometimes forget that this number is completely arbitrary. If we had only 8 fingers, things would be totally different. But 10 is what we went with, and it works just fine. Getting back to the apples, the basic operations we will learn first are addition and subtraction. Addition is the most basic arithmetic operation, and it represents the combination of 2 numbers to become a single number, or a sum. If you get 2 apples from one vendor and then 3 from another, how many apples did you get? Of course, we can easily count the resulting pile and see that there are 5. But how do we represent this mathematically? Using the symbols that are common of today, we would put the number 2, then the addition or plus symbol, and then the number 3, followed by an equals sign, and then the number 5. This is an equation, which is a statement of equality. The expression on the left is numerically equivalent with the expression on the right. This particular equation reads 2 plus 3 equals 5. With the word plus essentially meaning and the equal sign meaning is. 2 and 3 is 5, so 5 is the sum of this additive operation. The next operation that became necessary was subtraction, which is the inverse or opposite of addition, in that it doesn't find the sum of 2 numbers, it finds their difference. You bring all 5 of your apples home and you eat one of them. If one apple has been subtracted, how many are left? Again, it is easy to count and see that there are 4 left, but this result can also be calculated, which is much different from counting. We can write another equation with a 5, then the minus symbol, followed by a 1, then the equals sign, and the number 4. This reads 5 minus 1 equals 4, which essentially means 5 less 1 is 4. So 4 is the difference between 1 and 5. On a number line, this is the distance between the 2 numbers, and this is an excellent way to visualize subtraction. 14 minus 11 is 3, because 3 is the difference between the two numbers. It takes 3 to get from 11 to 14. Now that we have become familiar with the symbolic representation of these simple operations, we should discuss some applicable properties of numbers. Addition is commutative, in that the order in which numbers are added does not matter. 2 plus 3 equals 5, and 3 plus 2 also equals 5. Subtraction is not commutative. It does indeed matter which number is being subtracted from the other. 3 minus 2 is not the same as 2 minus 3. Addition is also associative. This means that if performing two successive additions, the order in which they are performed does not matter. 2 plus 3 plus 4 will be 9, no matter which numbers we add first. We can add the first two to get 5, and then add that to 4, or we can add the latter two to get 7, and then add that to 2. The result is the same. Subtraction is not associative. If we write down 5 minus 3 minus 2, we could do 5 minus 3 first. That gives us 2. And subtracting the other two, we get 0. If instead we do the 3 minus 2 first, we get 1, and 5 minus 1 is 4. So we can see that subtraction is not associative. We will learn all about the order of operations later, as well as other ways in which these kinds of properties become less obvious, yet very important. No matter how far we choose to go with math, and no matter how complicated equations appear to be, with symbols like square roots and logarithms and integrals, we must always remember that these symbols mean something concrete. They are rooted in the physical world, even if in a way that is more difficult to immediately conceptualize than the plus symbol. One goal of this series will be to make all the other mathematical operations as intelligible and relatable as addition and subtraction. Once you intimately understand what mathematical constructs represent, they no longer seem arbitrary and infuriating, but instead powerful, as their utility becomes apparent. So let's move forward and learn some more arithmetic. But first, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.